of Trade, DIlip Bhat, joins into our conversation. We've also been speaking to SP Tulsi and Ashwini Gujral and Mitesh Thakkar. So we have a full house right here on CNBC TV 18. DIlip, hi, afternoon. The stock of the day has been HDFC Bank. First the RBI ban, then the removal of that ban. A lot of people, you know, wrote to us talking about the kind of volatility that this stock created. But for a long-term investor, what do you see as the way forward now?
Really speaking, you know, HDFC Bank is one of those banks, as we all know, that you should have it in your core portfolio. And I think it never ceases to surprise everyone. Having said that, I think if you were to really measure it on a time frame basis, maybe it looks fully done with the price at the moment. And it was more of a technical factor that we all knew that because of which the price has gone up. From here on, I think probably it will have to spend some time on sideways for consolidation, but by far it still remains the best bank. So if you have a 3 to 6 months horizon, possibly it may not give you any great returns, but 12 months to 18 months still is a stock that you should hold in your portfolio from the resilience point of view as well as from a reasonable return point of view.
Okay, well, really the space of the moment right now is some of these penny stocks which are still there in F&O market. So JP of course is up 11% now. GMR Infra, by the way, has made a big intraday move. So let's pull up the intraday chart of GMR Infra as well. That stock is up about 3%. The other JP Group stocks as well, JP Power and Infra, have also made a move. Dilip, good afternoon. Is this bit worrisome the way some of these penny stocks are moving, or do you think they have reason to rally?
Well, Anuj, I think if we see that the most of the frontline stocks are really trading in an expensive territory at the moment, and the recovery is happening and the earnings have yet to return in a very big way to sober down their P's and make them look a lot more reasonable. And we have seen that the FIs are not so keen participants in this market at the moment. So you have domestic who have got inflows, you have got PMS who have got inflows, and you have HNIs who are active. So I think they really have to buy some of the stocks, and you know, a lot of them look for those alpha calls. So that is why we find that a lot of this things, a lot of money of the investors, HNI investors, and maybe possibly a few PMS also has gone into some of the mid-cap sector. And I think whenever we see that thing happening, you always find those lower micro-cap companies always really running away ahead. But I think surely this is worrisome, because out of the stocks that are moving, we find that hardly 10% are the ones, not even 10% of the you can really bet on, and you can extrapolate and say that they have a reasonable opportunity of making it to the even a reasonable cap story in next 3 to 4 years. So I think that will always remain a challenge, and also the liquidity factor. So surely you should be cautious, and I think it has to be very, very stock specific and bottoms up.
Okay, well, what would you do here? Because this was the other big story of the day, right? The way the stock fell after its weak JLR numbers. You think there's more derating to go, or is this a good time to be buying Tata Motors?
Well, I think it has the results and some of the commentary has disappointed, and though they have guided that the fourth quarter they will bounce back very quickly, but some of the issues do remain. But still, I think we ourselves have gone very much into the results and the conference call that followed that. Our own take is that maybe maximum 4 to 5% downside from here. But I think one should, one will always look to buy this stock at the lower levels. And I think to expect that it should cross 500 to 520 over medium to long term, I think appears to be a reasonable call for us. And I think from an investment point of view, I will certainly say that around these levels and slightly lower levels, one should look to buy.
DIlip, what's your pecking order as far as Pharma names are concerned, if you will want to buy anything?
Well, I think the pharma names, I think they are getting challenged by the valuations at the moment. You know, like when we were having our own discussion, the thing that was coming out is the generic companies like Teva and all, which are really addressing the same markets as the leading Indian pharma companies, They are not even trading half of the valuations as what some of these companies are trading at. So why should Indian pharma companies really trade so high? So I think that challenge remains, in my opinion, not just for the pharma companies, but across all the frontline companies. But that's a fair point that has to be taken. But having said that, I think this US FDA thing is something which is really inspiring a lot of fear in the minds of the people, which is where the valuations are really coming into question time and again. But my take is that these US FDA observations, something which will make this, especially the frontline companies, very strong, very solid. And I think they will make them good in the long run. But the entire thing is that within this pharma space, I would say that yes, I would still think of investing in the pharma space. Some names like Aurobindo Pharma, something like Lupin, and maybe Sun Pharma as something to give some kind of resilience on the downside. And some of the mid-cap names like, say, Thyrocare, which is more in the diagnostic sector. But I would still be positive on the sector, I think largely because of the growth factor and also because of the profitability.